A is given as 1, 2, 3, B is given as 3, 4, and C is 4, 5, 6. We have to find A cross B intersection B cross C. So A cross B is what? I'll tell you one way, but you know, we'll do it in this way, but there is another method so that the things can be, or this ordered pair can be made easily. So this A is AB, so just write this A as 1, 2, 3 and B here. Now in this A cross B, always remember that the first member should come from, the first member of this ordered pair should come from A. So this is A, this is A, and this is B. So 1, 2, 3, just write like this, 1, 2, 3. And now the second member should come from B. Write 3, 3, 3. I'll write 4 here. So these are the ordered pair. This is the way you can do it quickly. There is another method, that is you have to take a cross of B cross C Cartesian product. So this is B, this is C. So now 3, 4, 3, 5 and 3, 6. These are the first three members for 3, and then 4, 4, 4, 5 and 4, 6. 4, 4, 4, 5, 4, 6. Now for intersection, we have to find the ordered pair which are common. So we see only 3, 4 and 3, 4 are common here, others are not. So this is the intersection. Next we have A as 2, 3, B as 4, 5 and C as 5, 6. You have to find A cross B union C, A cross B intersection C and A cross B union A cross C. So let us start with this one. First of all, B union C. In this one and this one, B union C, just combine them. So 4, 5, 6. 5 is twice, so just write it once. 4, 5, 6 is B union C. Now A cross B union C is what? You have to multiply this A, that is 2, 3 with 4, 5, 6. So 2, 3 with 4, 5, 6. So 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. And then 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Next one is A cross B intersection C. So B is 4, 5 and C is 5, 6. So what is the common between them? Only 5. So 5 is common. Now in order to find A cross B intersection C, A is 2, 3 given here and this is 5. So it will be 2, 5 and 3, 5. Now A cross B and A cross C, it union of these two. So A cross B is what? A 2, 4, 2, 5. And 3, 4, 3, 5. A cross C is 2, 5, 2, 6 and 3, 5 and 3, 6. And now take the union of these two. Union means all the elements from A and B and the common ones need to be written once. So 2, 4, 2, 5, 3, 4, 3, 5, 2, 5, 2, 6, 3, 5, 3, 6. These are all the elements, but here we have 2, 5 and 2, 5 which is repeated. So we'll just write it once. Okay. And 3, 5 is also twice, so we'll write it once. A is given as 1, 2, 3 and B is 4 and C is 5. Now we have to verify whether this first one is A cross B union C. A cross B union C is equal to A cross B union A cross C. So let us take one by one. So now here this is B union C, means 4 and 5 are there, so 4, 5 will be B union C, and A cross B union C means 1, 2, 3 cross 4, 5. So 1, 4, 1, 5, 2, 4, 2, 5 and 3, 4, 3, 5. Coming to A cross B, this is A, this is B, we know that A and B already given, A and C is also given. So 1, 4, 2, 3, 3, 4, this is A cross B, and 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, this is A cross C. Now we have to take the union of this. And if you see, there is nothing common between these two. So all these members will come. But A cross B union C and A cross B union A cross C, if you see, these members and these members, they are exactly equal. They are exactly similar. So we can write these two are equal. Next one is A cross B intersection C is equal to, we have to verify that this is equal to A cross B intersection A cross C. So A is what? 1, 2, 3. B is 4, 5. Now take the intersection of B and C. Since there is nothing common, it will be empty or 5. 4 and 5, nothing is common, so 5. Now A cross B intersection C, that is 1, 2, 3 cross 5, means you have to take the intersection, the Cartesian product with empty is always empty. So this A cross B intersection C is phi. Now coming to the right hand side, which is here, if you see that A cross B is 1, 4, 2, 4 and 3, 4. A cross C is 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5. Now you need to take the intersection of these two. Since there is nothing common between these two sets, or you can say these two Cartesian products, phi will come. So we see here also phi comes, here also phi comes. The left hand side is not equal to right hand side. Hence it is verified. Next one is A cross B minus C. What is A cross B minus C? First let us find B minus C. So B minus C means taking out all from B which is in C, but it is having only 4, and it is having 5 which is not there. So only 5, only 4 will come, B minus C. Now A cross B minus C, that is 4 cross 1, 2, 3. This is 1, 4, 2, 4 and 3, 4. This is A cross B minus C. Coming to the right hand side, we have to find out A cross B minus A cross C. So A cross B is 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4. A cross C is 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5. Now just subtract. Subtracting means you have to subtract all the content which is common from A and right. So if you see here that you don't find anything common between these two. If you see, you don't find anything common between these two. So this will only come 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, 4. And if you compare it with A cross B minus C, this and these are equal. So hence verified. Next one is A is 1, 2, B is 1, 2, 3, 4, C is 5, 6, D is 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have to show that A cross C is a subset of B cross D. So let us find first this B cross D. So this will be 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7, 1, 8. Then 2, 5, 2, 6, 2, 7, 2, 8. Then 3, 5, 3, 6, 3, 7, 3, 8. Then 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, 7, 4, 8. So 4 into 4, 16 ordered pair will come. When it comes to A cross C, it will be, see, 1, this is 1, comma 2 and 5, comma 6. So 1, 5, 1, 6 and 2, 5, 2, 6. Now in this you see 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6. All is there. Let me cut it so that you understand that how this 1, 5 is there. Okay. So 1, 5, 1, 5 is there. 1, 6 is also there, 2, 5 is also there and 2, 6 is also there. So this is the subset of this one. So A cross C is a subset of B cross D. This has to be verified and we have verified it. The next one is A cross B intersection C is equal to A cross B intersection A cross C. So let us find out the first one. All these are there. So first we have to find out the B intersection C. So what is B and C? What is the common between them? Nothing is common. So 5 will come. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nothing is common for 5. 5. So when we cross it with A, that is 1, 2 cross or Cartesian product with 5. There is nothing common. So 5 will only come. Empty with any set, Cartesian product will also always be 5. Now taking the right hand side. Right hand side we have A 1, 3, 2, B as 1, 2, 3, 4. So what will be there? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. And 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4. Here. Now coming to A cross C, 1, 5, 1, 6 and 2, 5, 2, 6. But if you take the intersection of these two, you see nothing is common between these two sets. Now not this one, neither any of these terms are common. So it will be also 5. So hence verify that this is also 5, this is also 5. That is, both are giving you the result as 5, hence verify. If A is 1, 2, 3, B is 3, 4, C is 4, 5, 6, then we have to find A cross B intersection C and others. I'll just take the first one and then we'll go to the other one. So here we have B intersection C. What is common here? 4. Only 4 is common between these two. So 4 we will write. Then A cross B intersection C, A is 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3 cross 4. So 1, 4, 2, 4 and 3, 4. This will come. So A cross B intersection C is this one. The second one is, we have to find out A cross B intersection A cross C. So A cross B, these are AB. So 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4 and 3, 3, 3, 4. A cross C is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6 and then 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. And when we take the intersection, we have to find the elements or the ordered pair which are common between them. So we have this 1, 4, 1, 4, We have this 2, 4, 2, 4, and we have this 3, 4, 3, 4. So this will come. This is the result. Next one is A cross B union A cross C. So A cross B, this A cross B, or rather A, this is third one. So A cross B union C. Let us do this first one. Third one, A cross B union C. So B union C is what? 3, 4, 4, 5, 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6 will be there. 4 will be written only once, and we combine all the elements. So B union C is this one. When we take A cross B union C, A cross B union C, that is 1, 2, 3 cross 3, 4, 5, 6. So what will come? 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. And 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. And 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. This will come. Now the fourth one is A cross B and union A cross C. So this A cross B and A cross C we have already done here. So what we will do? I'll just see which ordered pairs are repeating. So 1, 4 is repeating, so we'll not use it. Then 2, 4 is repeating, so we'll not use it. Only once we will use it. And then we have 3, 4. So this is we are not going to use. So what will be the answer? 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 3, 3, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 2, 5, 2, 6, 3, 5, 3, 6. So this will be the set. This is the answer. Now we have to prove that A union B cross C is equal to A cross C union B cross C. So when we say A is equal to B, if these two are sets, then A should be a proper subset of B. This we have to show. And B is also a proper subset of A. This we have to show. If this is done, we can say that A and B are equal. So what we will do here is, because this is a cross, so Cartesian product is there. So we have to take two elements or an ordered pair here. So A comma B, let us assume that it is an arbitrary element. Arbitrary element means it can be any element. Or this is an ordered pair, any ordered pair, which belongs to A union B cross C. So when this belongs, that means A should belong to A union B, that is the left hand side part of the cross, and B should belong to C, that is the right hand part of the cross. So that means A belongs to A union B and B belongs to C. Now when A belongs to A union B, that means A belongs to A or A belongs to B, keep it in the bracket, and B belongs to C. Now when you say that A belongs to A and B, this A belongs to B, what we can do here is, since this B belongs to C is with AND, so you can take it here, that is B belongs to C, because it is AND, they both are true simultaneously. So you can put it here, B belongs to C, and you can take this here, that is A belong to C, you can take it here, and you can always write B belong to C, because this can be repeated, no problem. So this shows A belongs to A and B belongs to C means AB belongs to A cross C, right? A, this term is a first pair of first ordered pair element, and this is second ordered pair element. Here also A belongs to B and B belongs to C means AB belongs to B cross C. Now this is OR, so we can use a union sign. So when we started with AB belongs to A union B cross C, and we came up to A comma B belongs to A cross B union B cross C, that means this has to be a subset of this one. So A union B cross C is a proper subset of A cross C union B cross C. Now we'll do it otherwise, that is we will do in the reverse order. So now we have A cross C union B cross C. Let us assume that X, Y, this is an arbitrary element which belongs to this one, A cross C union B cross C. So when X, Y belongs to A cross C union B cross C, that means this should belong here or this should belong here. This means X belongs to A and Y belongs to C because this is a Cartesian product. This also means X belongs to B and Y belongs to C. Now what you can do, you see, this is already given that X belongs to A and Y belongs to C, and also here this is with AND. So X belongs to B and Y belongs to C. So this is already being taken, so you just take it here. This we are taking it here. And Y belongs to C is twice with AND, so we can write it once. So X belongs to A and we have taken this X belongs to B here. So X belongs to A or X belongs to B means X belongs to A union B. And this of course remains here. That means X belongs to A union B, and this is for cross, and this is C. So X belongs to A union B cross C. So we started with this, XY belongs to this one, and come up to XY belongs to A union B cross C. That is, this is also a proper subset of this one. This is also a proper subset of this one. So when we have showed that A is a proper subset of B and B is a proper subset of A, That means A is equal to B, that is this side is equal to this side. Next one is, we have to prove that A intersection B cross C is equal to A cross C intersection B cross C. What we will do here, again we'll do the same thing. We start with arbitrary A comma B, and this we say that it belongs to A cross B cross C, A intersection B cross C. So this is left hand side of the cross, this is right hand side of the Cartesian product. So A should belong to this one, A intersection B, and B should belong to C. Now A belongs to A intersection B means A belongs to A and A belongs to B. So when it is and, that means we can take this here and take this here. So now taking B belongs to C here, A belongs to B here, and this we can write once again because it doesn't matter, all are and. So A belongs to A and B belongs to C means A belongs to A, this AB, both AB belongs to A cross C. Again here AB belongs to B cross C. So that means AB belongs to A cross C intersection B cross C. We started with this one, we proved that AB also belongs to this one, that is this is a proper subset of this one. So A intersection B cross C is a proper subset of A cross C intersection B cross C. We'll now do it in the reverse order. So let us assume XY be the arbitrary element of A cross C intersection B cross C. That means X belongs to A cross C and this intersection means and. So X, comma Y belongs to A cross C and XY belongs to B cross C. So what does this mean? X belongs to A and Y belongs to C. This also means X belongs to B and Y belongs to C. And we have all and, so what you can do, you can take it here and Y belongs to C, you can write just once. So now this means X belongs to A intersection B because X and X both belong to AB, that is it has to be intersection, and Y belongs to C. So this can be combined as XY, this X and Y. So X comma Y belongs to A cross B in cross Cartesian product of C. So we started with this and we came up to XY belongs to A intersection B cross C. So this is a proper subset of this one. So when A is proper subset of B and B is proper subset of A, that means these two has to be equal. Now if A cross B is a proper subset of C cross D and A cross B is not equal to phi, that means it has some value, it is not phi. So we have to prove that A is a proper subset of C and B is a proper subset of D. So here A comma B, we start with A comma B. This is an arbitrary element of A cross B. So A comma B is belonging to A cross B. That means A belongs to A and B belongs to B. Now since AB belongs to C cross D also, why? Because AB is a proper subset of CD. Now when this is a proper subset, that means all the pairs, all the ordered pairs of A cross B should belong to, or it is inside C cross D also. So when we write A comma B belongs to A cross D, that means A comma B should belongs to C comma D also because this is a proper subset. That means A belong to C and B belong to D. When we say A belong to A, B belong to B, we say A belong to C, B belong to D. From here, it means A belong to A means A belong to C. That is A is a proper subset of C. From here, B belong to B and B belong to D. That is, B belong to B and B belong to D. That means B is a proper subset of, this one is proper subset of D. So hence, we have proved it.